I'm going to do something crazy again. That craziness is a $10,000 to $100,000 trading challenge on Femex. I think it's possible. We've done this several times before. So today, I'm going to start the challenge by looking at the price of Bitcoin and explaining my thoughts as to where the price of Bitcoin is heading. I've already opened a couple of trades for that challenge, and if you're interested in what's to come, slap a like on today's video. Let's make $10,000 into $100,000. And if you want to follow along with the series, subscribe. I'd encourage everyone to subscribe. Now, yesterday we didn't hit the like goal, so there's no $1,000 to give away today. But if we hit 1,000 likes on this video, I'm going to give $1,000 to somebody that leaves a comment in the comment section below. I just want to prove to you these giveaways aren't fake, they are real, and I do message the winners of them and tell them that they have won. That happens, and you should enter it right now. Slap a like, subscribe, and let's crack on. Let us go to moon. So starting out the $10,000 to $100,000 challenge, the first trade I'm going to take today is on this thing called Vanry. Now, for those of you familiar, Vanry is an interesting platform. It's like a media blockchain, and they've been doing a lot of improvements recently. Here on the 30 minute chart, you can see the price has come up from 13 cents to 17 cents. But if we zoom out a little bit and go over to something like the 3 hour chart, you can see that it's been a pretty rough period of time for Vanry because the price was up here at 32 cents and now it's down here at 17 cents. Being that I'm expecting a boost in the altcoin market pretty soon, I think this is a safe place for us to start the challenge off. So I'm going to do it live right now on this video, and I'm going to place the first trade of this kind of trading challenge. I'm going to purchase with I've got $1,000 available in my account right now because there's a couple of other trades open taking up that available margin in the account. The first trade here is this Axel trade. The second trade here is on Corti, both of which are in around $5,000 worth of profit. Now, I'm particularly excited about the Corti trade because I think my entry on that is really good, and I think that's going to go up to around 20 cents. I'm going to count that as part of the challenge because I did only place that trade yesterday and I posted about it in various other groups. However, if you do want to keep up to date with this challenge on every single trade that I'm making, because sometimes there might not be time to post a video about every single trade, all of that is going to be available within the CSE Discord group. To join the CSE Discord group, all you need to do is sign up to CSE Plus, for which you'll find a link in today's video description. A couple of other trades open, one on Pepe to remind me that I want a long Pepe with some decent size, and the other one open on Phantom, and I'm going to explain why I've got that trade open later on in today's video. But right now, I'm going to open up this trade here on Vanry. Now I'm going to place my long position here on a limit order. You should always be trading on limit orders because it saves a fortune on fees, and I'm going to use 50% of my available balance on long 50x cross, which means I'm basically using 25x leverage on $500. So if I press long there, it should give me this screen right here. If I press confirm, it will place my trade in the order book right there. I've not currently opened the trade. I've got to wait for somebody to sell into my trade right there, and then that will open up the overall position. So if we hear a ding in today's video, we'll know that position has been opened. But that's right now what I'm placing the trade for. The reason I'm going long on Vanry is mainly because we've had this huge run up in price, we've had a huge decline in price, and I think it looks very strong going forward. And if we get kind of like a 10-20% pump from here, that should be a nice little gain to start off this challenge with. Now, in terms of the trading strategy for this $10,000 to $100,000 challenge, I'm starting off slow, like I do with every single altcoin challenge. I'm not trying to shoot for the moon straight away. I'm not trying to over leverage myself and find myself in a bunch of trouble. I'm going to take it slow, take it sensible. There are other things that I'm doing with my own portfolio that are less slow and less sensible, and we will discuss them in today's video. So make sure you've slapped a like on it and keep watching to the end. But right now, we're going long on Vanry, and I think it's looking pretty strong. In terms of things that Bitcoin is doing right now, Bitcoin is also looking very strong. The current price of it just below $66,000. It's had a significant rise up in value again today, rising from around $64,500 up to around $66,000. The question is, do we get rejected at this range right here? Because this is a bit of a contentious range. If we look at this range here, it's kind of the box in the middle. You've got a box at the top, a box at the bottom, and a box in the middle. This is the middle trading range. So within this range here, we can probably expect some sideways movement. However, because of Ethereum has been trading against Bitcoin recently, continuing its downtrend, like this is the daily chart. It's been looking pretty horrendous. Every single pump that it's done recently has been dumped on. Even today, we had a pump up yesterday, and today the value of it dropped again 0.5% against the value of Bitcoin. That has meant that Ethereum's price is not looking quite as healthy as what Bitcoin is right now, trading somewhere around $3,180. You can see it there, $3,180 is the current price of Ethereum. If we go over here to the 1 hour chart, you can see that on a 1 hour chart, we've got a W reversal pattern forming on the price of Ethereum. Very similar to what Bitcoin is doing, with the overall target for this range being up here, somewhere around $3,560. The question is that gonna come from a price increase in Ethereum, or is that gonna come from a price increase in Bitcoin? And what I mean by that is Bitcoin gonna pump and Ethereum just kind of tag along for the ride? I don't know. I'm pretty confident that at this point in time, there aren't that many more bullish catalysts left for Bitcoin, and instead altcoins should make a bit of a run for the moon. We can look at some of those catalysts that Bitcoin has got going on right now, one of which is Bitcoin percentage of addresses in profit. Every single time this chart reaches the top of this range, you can see that it gets rejected from it. And that is no different right now, with us being rejected from the top of the range. However, generally, when we do reach the top of the range, we do tend to stay around there and we keep retesting it. That is what I'm expecting for Bitcoin to do. I am expecting Bitcoin to make new all-time highs pretty soon. I think that's going to also be reflected in the price of Ethereum. I think it's going to reflect it across the entire market. And I think that right now, to be longing altcoins and Bitcoin is probably a smarter idea than shorting. It's also important to consider other indicators right now, like the net unrealized profit and loss ratio. Because on the net unrealized profit and loss ratio, you can see it over here on the price of Bitcoin. We're towards the bottom, to be honest, of the belief slash denial phase, heading back into the optimism slash anxiety phase. I think that we're in a very strong place right now. There is so much upside left in this chart. And to be honest, we've never actually reached the top of the euphoria and greed stage of the Nuple. And the Nuple, to be honest, has been one of the most accurate indicators in the past, and I expect nothing to change on that. The final indicator that I want to look at in terms of on-chain indicators right now would be the Bitcoin Rainbow Price Chart Indicator. Now, on this indicator, you can see that in the past, Bitcoin's price has continued within this range. And right now, again, should in theory be no different, with the price of Bitcoin being towards the bottom of the bull market. Like, we've not got going yet. And every single bull market in history has kicked off after a Bitcoin halving event. That's what we've just experienced, and that's why I'm so bullish, and it's why Vanry is going to make the first position that I'm opening within this altcoin challenge. Did the position trigger? Let's have a look. No, it's not triggered yet, and the price is now pumping, which is a bit of a shame, but I'm going to be disciplined here. And this is one of the dangers of using a limit order. Yeah, you see, look at this. My order's here. It's not triggered, and now we're running above it. And now he's going to want me to form a win at these slightly higher prices. And to be honest, I really kind of want to. But I'm going to hold out for another 5 minutes and see what happens here. Either way, I will be placing a long position on Vanry, because I think the price of it is going back towards the mid 20 cent level, and I'm pretty optimistic about it. If you are interested in joining me in this challenge, check out Femex. You'll find a link for it in today's video description. If you use that link, you get a nice deposit bonus. And if you're from the US, just use a VPN and you can use Femex as well. In other news, anyway, there's a lot of things to discuss in today's video, one of which is the Bitcoin miners upgrade power centers and get into AI to brace for slashed revenue post-halving. Now, I'm right now getting into AI because over here you can see Y8U token, the fuel of the ecosystem of the Y8U AI universe. Now, Y8U is listing tomorrow on April the 23rd at 2 p.m. UTC on Gate and MXC. It's an ape terminal launch, so it probably do quite well at launch, and I'm pretty excited for what's to come. The purpose of this particular token here is that Y8U will allow miners to process raw data belonging to users ranging from AI enthusiasts endorsing celebrities with Web3 believers to create models. In return, the AI miners will be compensated with Y8U tokens based on the AI model fidelity and demand via our genomic consensus. The Y8U token will empower third-party holders to bid for the right to use digital DNA of others to create derivative media content, creating a thriving decentralized AI-powered media market. Staking Y8U tokens will also additionally yield daily trustless return and deter malicious usage of or infringement of personal data. Now, from my perspective, in this bull market, I expect AI is going to be one of the major narratives. And not only that, but storing your data in a decentralized manner and being able to use your data as a digital passport, so to speak. It's going to be a very popular area of the industry. This is what Y8U is allowing you to do. I think it's pretty exciting. And the most exciting thing of all is that it's launching on the Humans blockchain. Now, many of you are investors in the Humans blockchain. That's Heart Token, currently with a $160 million market cap or a $211 million fully diluted market cap. Over the past year or so, you can see it's had some nice upwards price action recently, and then even more recently, a little bit of downwards price action. It's around, what's that, about 60% as high as its all-time high here? No, it's about 50% lower than its all-time high here, which was very short-lived anyway. But it's about a 50% discount from the highs right now. I think that this is going to benefit significantly from the launch of the Y8U token, because it gives humans more utility overall, because Y8U is building on top of the Humans blockchain. And if it works out and it all goes very well, we can probably expect some significant price action in the Humans AI arena. From that perspective, this is why I'm so bullish on the altcoin market right now. I think looking at overall, there are so many different altcoins launching lots of different areas of utility, and all you need is a few different areas of utility to really captivate the market, and then everything's getting sent. I'm very bullish on altcoins right now. I don't know if you can tell. So let's briefly check in on some of our altcoin investments. Starting off with AIT Protocol, the downtrend appears to have stopped. We perhaps in the next couple of days are going to officially break the downtrend and make a move back to the upside. Now the move when it comes should be pretty significant. Currently we sat around 40 cents. If we make the move up to just that level right there, that's 50 cents. That is a 25% increase in price. I'm optimistic about AIT Protocol. Brett has been performing very strong again, currently trading around 6.5 cents. Pretty excited about Brett, think he's going to do good things. Phantom, part of my long-term positioning. Dogecoin, again, part of my long-term positioning. Chainlink, I don't know how this is so low in price. It just is, and this is its Bitcoin valuation. Its US dollar valuation doesn't look that bad. It's somewhere near $20. But currently, its Bitcoin valuation is down so very badly. In what kind of period of time is this? So in this period of time, 70 days, it's down 57% against Bitcoin top to bottom. That is pretty horrendous. When we're looking at the price of Vanry, of course, is part of the altcoin challenge. The trade, unfortunately, has still not triggered. However, I am hoping it'll trigger. Then we've got the Coty trade right here. I'm, of course, also long on Coty right now on Femex. You can see that trade there. It's currently $5,800 in a profit. Also part of the challenge going forward. And again, Coty should do some very big things this bull market. I think around this 13 cent price is very cheap. And to be honest, on the way up, I wish I bought more around 13 cents because it ran up to around 30 cents, which is around a 2x from where it is right now. Then we've got APRS, which is Aperion, currently now 59 cents, still just stagnating around these ranges, but I'm expecting this to turn around pretty soon. Heart blockchain should be doing very well because Heart is currently, I mean, this is against Bitcoin. The reason why I'm looking at things against Bitcoin rather than US dollar values is, look, I don't care what that US dollar value is. It means absolutely nothing to me. That number right there means nothing. This number matters. That number matters because that tells us how it's performing against Bitcoin, and that gives us a better view on the market. Currently, we're low. We can see that we're low in this chart. However, we appear to be finding some support and hopefully bounce to the upside again pretty soon because of what is going on with Y8U. And then finally in today's video, Glimmer, currently up 2 cents since yesterday's video where it was around 32 cents. Now it's about 34 cents. Up 3% apparently in the past 24 hours, although that's slightly more than 3%. I'm optimistic about what's going on with Glimmer, Polkadot, and that whole ecosystem as well. Now, if there was no logistical time limit on a video, I can talk about this stuff forever, which is why I'm going on a live stream this evening. If you want to watch that live stream, there's a main channel link in today's video description. Click on the main channel link, subscribe to the main channel, turn on channel notifications. I'm going live. Give it a watch when I do go live. We're going to be talking altcoins. We're going to be rating altcoins. Have a fantastic day, everybody. Thank you all for watching today's video. Don't forget, slap a like on it. Let's try and get 1,000 likes. If you get 1,000 likes, I'll give away $1,000 to somebody that leaves a comment in the comment section below. See you all in a bit. Have a nice day, and see you all on the live stream in a bit. Bye-bye.